another beautiful day here at the Cycleland Speedway. Points race number 4. This is our 4th appearance here at this place this season. Season started out kind of late. You know, we had quite a few off weekends there with the whole COVID thing. And now we're back in full swing and Cycleland races all the way up until October. So a lot of races will be here. We won't be here for all of them, but it's going to be an exciting just to see this place progress throughout 2020. They're doing a little bit of track prep right now here on the track. Just got done watering it. His hot laps will be up in about 30 minutes. We are back though, as usual, in the factory QRC number 18T. Our last two weekends here have been super successful. We got our first open win at Cycleland, and then last weekend we ran 4th from starting 6th in a completely different car than we started out the night. So hopefully we can carry that speed into tonight. We pulled a 21, probably gonna be out in about group 6 or 7, expecting anywhere from 30 to 35 opens, so a great car count, and we are gonna get the night started out first with hot laps and into qualifying. Of 39 opens here. They do about 4 per group, so we're about halfway through the open lineup. Laid down a pretty good lap. We were 5th quick and fastest in our group. We need to try to stay in the top 6 to make the trophy dash. Felt like we did a really, really good lap there. 2 consistent ones. I don't think they were too far off each other. Maybe could have got a little bit quicker. We were at 10.87, quick times at 10.72. Track's gonna slowly get a little bit slower each group, I'm assuming. It's just starting to lose a little bit of grip around the bottom. Eventually it will start moving up probably for the heat races to the middle, depending on what they do to rework it. This engine though, Jimmy put together a really nice bullet for us. I'm excited for points race number 4 here at Cycleland. A great start. We'll see where we end up. All right, they just did a full track rework here at the Cycleland Speedway before the heat race action gets started. Really when he went out there, used the tiller, tilled up the bottom, tilled up the top side, and like I said, did a pretty big rework on the racetrack, sprayed some water on it. It's 93 degrees here in Chico, California, so it's very, very warm. The sun has been shining, mainly down here on turns 1 and 2. There's a little bit of shade on 3 and 4, so it tends to hold more grip down there. We ended up 6th quick in the open division, so that's great. We made the dash. We'll start on the pole of that later tonight. Probably by the time we roll out for that, the sun will be down. So completely different conditions. Now we're just gonna hang out for a little bit, see what the racetrack does. And like I said, a great start to the night here at Cycleland.
Taylor Holmes, great job on the road to Ashland. It looked like you guys were kind of seeing a problem up around the Burgess track. Do you think it'll widen out for the future?
Absolutely, yeah. It's great to be in the Trophy Dash here. It's funny, we were joking. Don't see me in the Trophy Dash too much here in cycling, let alone winning a Trophy Dash. So really fun. Track's awesome. It's starting to widen out. I think Mo Morales is going to do a little bit of track prep, and it should be prime just like last week.
All right, rolling up in the future. Can you get to the front, get your second one of the year?
Absolutely, yeah. I think the growth we've had over these last 4 weeks at Cycling have been the best I've ever had here. So it's really exciting to see the speed. Just got to thank Factory QRC, Jimmy, Burris Racing, Tire Durst Incorporated, and hopefully see us up front in the future.
All right, we'll see what you can do. Good luck, bud.
Absolutely, thank you.
There you have it, Tanner.
All right, heading out for the Open A main event. We're just going to try to repeat the speed that we had there in the Open Trophy Dash. I felt so good around the top side of the racetrack. Like I mentioned in my interview, the growth we've had in these last four races at Cycling has been amazing. Yeah, heading out there right now, we're starting fifth. Like I said, just try to go as far forward as possible. You know, I think the bottom's all right, top's looking pretty good, and we're just going to try to head to the front. So we made it back to Southern Oregon. It is Sunday evening here, and I know I'm pretty late, but happy Father's Day to everyone watching this video. I hope you guys all had a great day. Thank you so much for tuning in. We are back on my big camera as well. That's why I wanted to wait to do the outro. I was using my little camera because I was a little irresponsible, forgot my battery for this thing, so I was just trying to make a vlog work throughout the night. Anyway, to recap Cycleland for Saturday, it was a lot of fun being there. You know, Cycleland is a place that I'm starting to really, really enjoy going to. There was a period in my racing career where I really didn't enjoy it. It was somewhere where I really struggled. I tried to get better. I had some good nights and had some bad nights. But the racetrack has just been phenomenal these last 2 weeks. Really, really racy. You got a bottom, you got a top, and it's not really gotten to the point where it's taking rubber. Kind of did a little bit at the end of the open feature, but that's just something that you expect with that many cars. It's really hard to have a perfect track every weekend. As for our night, you guys kind of saw we had an unfortunate ending. A great start, though, to it. You know, qualified sixth, made the dash out of 39 open outlaw carts at Cycleland, won the dash from the pole, you know, had a pretty solid start. Casey McLean kind of got me. He went to the top side. We were able to slide him and then never look back. Had really, really good speed in the dash. I believe our best time was an 11.08, and the second fastest car on the racetrack was an 11.25. And for running the top side like we did there, that's another huge improvement that I had. I felt like I made some really, really good laps, and we were hoping to carry that into the feature. We didn't really make too many changes. The track didn't change a whole lot besides just move up a little bit closer to the wall, and that's where we kind of had some trouble. What ended up happening is, I believe around lap one or two, I didn't really have a great start to the race. Made a few of the wrong moves, lost a few spots, but once again, my left front knuckle rolled forward, and Landon had a similar issue on his, except his knuckle sheared off. I believe it was his right front. And so we kind of had some issues there, and from that, you know, my car just didn't handle exactly what we wanted it to, and it was harder to, or really could only run the bottom side of the racetrack. When I went to the top, it just was kind of inconsistent. It wanted to get tight and then snap loose. But like I said, I had a few issues with my front end, and then what ended up happening with about 6 or 7 laps to go, I kind of got into the curb a little bit hard, and the engine kind of bogged, and that was our first night after a rebuild on it, after you saw our engine trouble last week, and it just didn't really seem to come back to the life. I wasn't sure if it was a false alarm or what happened, so I just decided to pull it in the infield. My race was pretty much over anyway. Not much of a difference between running 5th or 6th and 14th. I mean, it all is pretty much similar to me unless you win. So that did kind of suck. One of the funny things that we all joked about in the trailer after the race, my teammate Landon and our car owner Jimmy, he came in, he was like, you know, we went from winning 2 races in a row to both being parked in the infield, and that just shows how our sport is. It can be so humbling sometimes. You know, you can have some really good races, and then, you know, when you're doing good, you might just have a bad night here and there, and you got to recover from it. Overall, though, we go to Cycleland just to have fun. No points racing. Awesome to run with Factory QRC, as well as get Carly some seat time in her open outlaw cart. She had a phenomenal race. I wish I would have had a GoPro on her. She went 21st to 6th, was hard charger, and was coming to the front. So anyway, I'll see you guys all in the next video. Thank you for tuning in to another exciting racing vlog, as we all have many more throughout the summer of 2020. Would like to thank Jimmy Elledge and everyone at Factory QRC, Burris Racing Tire, Jet Fitness, Durst Incorporated, and everyone that supports the Factory Kart program. Good luck to them for the rest of the season. We're gonna try to hit as many races as possible and have Carly get to run a little bit with her kart with Truck Shop Motors. Anyway, see you guys all in the next video. Deuces.